Hi everyone, I'm Christine Tully, President and Executive Writing Coach for Defend and Publish. Welcome to episode 41. Do you need a writing coach? You may be listening to this podcast if you've stuck with us through all the 40 previous episodes, or maybe just discovering us now. But the episodes that we put out for Defend and Publish offer writing tips and kind of short snippets of advice for you to try on your own. One of the things that we do at Defend and Publish as our major part of our work is writing coaching, and I would argue the teaching of writing. If you have not heard much about our writing coaching company, what we end up doing for many faculty, graduate students, and other types of writers that need to get some work done with a little bit of support, we do offer a variety of services. And I wanted to use this episode to just talk through a couple of things, how you might do those if you're interested in seeking out more support, and some other ways that you might be able to do some of this on your own. Because not everybody needs a writing coach. I think that's the first thing to throw out there to those of you that are listening. But if you're intrigued by the idea, I just want to put out a couple of things why a writing coach might be useful at some point in your career. So the primary reason that most people come to Defend and Publish is because they're having trouble finishing a project. That doesn't mean they're in trouble. It means that sometimes they're just stuck on a project and they need to get some advice. Maybe a large project like a scholarly monograph or an edited collection is running away from them. They're not sure where all the parts of the project are. They're getting a little disorganized. They're getting discouraged. We see faculty, graduate students, and writers out in the community just with, kind of the case of writer's block where they just can't figure out what to say next. Occasionally, we'll see graduate students who are ABD and are having trouble finishing the last of the loop. Particularly for graduate students that are writing dissertations, this tends to be a time where classes fall away and then they're on their own writing. And of course, as most graduate students realize, the committee members that you have often help shape how that experience is going to go for you. So for students that have committees that maybe are unsupportive or too busy to be as supportive as the student needs, sometimes those students will come seek us for writing coaching. So what does writing coaching look like? It can take a variety of forms. Some students will come to us because they actually want to have us come read the comments from their advisor or read drafts of their writing and have us work with their writing with them in a conversation or in an exchange of writing where we serve as writing teachers. One of the great things about Defend and Publish is that the majority of our coaches on staff and most of the coaches that come into the company have doctoral degrees in rhetoric and writing, so in writing studies, or they have them in English and they end up teaching writing. So by far, most of the coaches that come to us have either been writing teachers at the college level. Many of them have had their own graduate students, their own graduate programs. They've served in writing centers and writing labs on our campuses. And many of them, like myself, hold academic positions elsewhere as faculty that mentor and teach graduate student writers and run faculty writing groups and services of that nature. So one of the things that happens is if you come to Defend and Publish and you're looking for a writing coach, we always have a conversation with you through our initial consultations to let you know, to let you talk to us about what it is that you need. We may find in that course of that conversation that it's not a good match. Maybe we're not what you're looking for, but we do offer free 30-minute consultations. So it's a good way to get 30 minutes of free writing coaching to see if you like it. And if you're interested in that, you can check out our website. It's just defendandpublish.com. There's a button on the homepage if you scroll down to schedule an initial consultation. So no strings attached, doesn't cost anything, but you can try us out and see if you like what writing coaching can possibly do for you. So coaching can take other types of forms. So a traditional way would be where you're working with a coach and having an exchange of writing. The coach is offering suggestions, offering comments on drafts of paper. So lots of times we exchange, say, Google Docs or Microsoft Word drafts. But other times coaching can take the form of a phone call of support. So sometimes students or faculty writers need accountability. This is sometimes the case with faculty members that are needing to get some publications in before they apply for tenure. And so we have several clients working with us right now that just need that accountability every single week, where they have to report what kind of writing that they've done. And then the faculty or the writing coach will work with them to make sure that they're getting that writing done. So they'll talk through different strategies they might use through the week. Some are time management, but some are actual strategies to how to accomplish some of the writing tasks that are. So for example, if someone needs help trying to figure out a methodology section and they need to work on that during a particular week, the coach will explore that with the client and figure out, well, what do you need to have in that methodology section? Let's talk through what your methodology is. And a lot of what we do as coaches is listen to these projects. So either their articles or their books or their dissertations. And the nice thing with the coaches all having PhDs, this is a way that we're able to engage in an intellectual discussion with you about your project. So that's something that many of our clients find very valuable, because they can present their idea to another academic and use that other academic as a sounding board to get feedback on their ideas. And this helps round out maybe committee support for graduate students, but also for faculty that are in various types of universities where there are varying levels of faculty development support. A lot of times there's teaching programs at these institutions, but not a lot in terms of faculty scholarship and helping a new faculty member or even a faculty member post-tenure figure out how they're going to do their writing. So that's a lot of what we do. Another service that we offer that I would argue is a little bit unique is that we also do writing project management. Completing a writing project, whether it's a dissertation or an article, requires several stages of project management. And so many of our clients come to us because they need someone to help them draw up a project management plan. We do that at Defend and Publish. We draw up individual plans and we work with the clients to have not only the plan itself, but also some accountability and support built in, where someone is checking with you on your plan to see how you're doing and making sure that you're meeting your writing goals. So that's a lot of what we offer at Defend and Publish. Certainly we do this podcast, so of course this is a free resource. We do put out occasional free webinars, 1-hour webinars, so you can see some topics we're working on. Another option that you might be interested in is our monthly workshops. These are 3-hour workshops, and they're usually held on Wednesdays. They are on a topic of kind of relevance for that particular month. So in September, we offered one on writing project management and organizing multiple writing projects to get them completed in the course of the semester. In October, we're offering self-regulated learning. So if you're someone that really struggles to do the independent work of writing articles and books and just, you know, getting into doing that work without having somebody pushing on you to do it, or having a deadline, this could be the perfect workshop for you, because we work with writers that so they can learn some strategies to make themselves not more motivated, but more regulated in their behaviors in terms of how they approach writing. And that workshop is being presented by Melissa Quackenbush, who does a lot of research in that area. So she is also a professor and or a PhD, and she's able to present that research from an academic point of view, but also with practical strategies and tips. So one of the nice things about these workshops, if you're interested in attending, is that they're very cost effective for 3 hours. We have links to them on our website. You can go check those out. But we also offer free templates that are customizable during all of our workshops. You can take those with you and also get the chance to work with the writing coach who's presenting at that workshop to get some questions and answers about your own projects answered. So it's not necessarily a group coaching scenario, but usually there's a time for everybody to talk about their projects a little bit, exchange ideas, and get new information. So any of those options might be great for you. So I encourage you to check us out. I also want to say a quick note about why a writing coach might not be right for you. You know, many faculty are plugging along okay on their projects. It doesn't mean you're doing great, but you're still producing articles and books and things like that, and you're putting them out without that. And sometimes graduate students and faculty don't want writing coaching because well, certainly there's a financial element to it, but sometimes they like to have their own schedule and their own things. And sometimes working with a coach is not necessarily a good match. But others, I would say, do find the investment worthwhile, because the one thing that I would argue that coaching can do, and I'm going to just close on this note, is that I do believe that coaching can get you there faster than you might get on your own, because you do have another sounding board with someone who is also an academic and can kind of see through some of the things that might be challenges and suggest new ways to approach them. So that alone, the novelty of approach and also many strategies and tips to kind of boost where you are, it might be worth checking it out. So if you're interested in checking us out, the website has a button for a free consultation on the homepage. Workshops are on the homepage. You can check those out. And we'll be back to presenting our regular content next week. But I wanted to take this moment to talk through some of the services that we're now offering and invite you to check us out. Happy writing.